Let's continue our discussion on the arrest of Alice Go. We're now joined by Philippine Justice Undersecretary Raul Vasquez. Undersecretary Vasquez, good morning to you, sir.
Hi, good morning, Karen, and good morning to your viewers and listeners.
All right, so we have two senior officials from the government, Secretary Bengur Abalos and PNP Chief General Romel Marbil, who are in Indonesia right now to pick up Alice Go. Ang unang tanong, there are reports that the Indonesian government wants a prisoner swap. Have they formally asked for this, sir? And is that allowed under our laws?
We have no visibility on such formal request, and as far as we're concerned, it's just in the news. Mm-hmm. So the focus is now to make sure, Karen, that Alice Gowo is brought back to the country, whether through the efforts of SILG Benhur and PNP head Marbil, who are there already. And incidentally, to ensure that such an operation would be successful, we also sent our NBI and BI team last night again.
Okay.
In order to facilitate an immigration transfer, in order to ensure that such a return would be a reality.
Oo, so apat na palang nandun, may NBI rin at may BI. All right, Justice Secretary Boying Remulla yesterday had he had criticized the Bureau of Immigration chief, right, for I think not coordinating with the DOJ. What hasn't the BI done?
As far as the initial report goes, they already had information of Alice Gowo having left a few days before this matter came out in the open through the news. So he thought that there was some problems in the failure of the immigration people in not informing the head of the office, the Secretary of Justice himself, of things that are of so much importance in terms of our law enforcement, of which the DOJ is at the forefront.
Mm-mm. Okay, and the Secretary does not believe the story that supposedly they had taken the back door, took a boat, natulog ng ilang araw. Sabi niya, ano sila? Natulog sa lambat? Parang pelikula yan? Parang ganun ang sinabi niya, eh, no? Kasi yeah. May punto, we always talk about going back door, going to Sabah, but we fail to think it's many, many days of crossing open sea, right?
Correct. Probably they must have watched Born Legacy. Remember the ending?
Born Identity.
I'm sorry. Yes. So, Rachel Weisz and Jeremy Rayner, who were the actors there. And, you know, but, you know, kidding aside, really, it is a difficult and almost impossible task to do that, because it would be passing through a huge body of water that is crisscrossed with lawless elements, pirates here and there. So it's difficult. Not only would the travel conditions be almost unbearable, but three people to travel under those circumstances, as allegedly narrated by Sheila Gore during her Senate testimony, that somehow strains credibility or belief.
Oh, so essentially, I think what the DOJ secretary is driving at is really the responsibility of the Bureau of Immigration. This is it, right? In how Alice Go and companions left the country. Yun talaga. You are calling the BI into account.
Well, the only way that you could travel from an archipelagic country like the Philippines would be by sea or by air. And since the sea transport seems one that would test one's normal credulity, so to speak, then the only option was would be the air travel. And, you know, it's not impossible, but probable, perhaps, that such thing happened. The only problem is that we haven't pieced up the pieces yet. So, yes. So in a manner of speaking, and the NVI and other law enforcement agencies are trying to backtrack and verify this matter.
Oh, because it's quite confusing. The first report is July 18. She arrived in Kuala Lumpur or somewhere in Malaysia through Batik Air. Yun yung unang report na lumabas, sir, di ba? Batik Air. So that would mean you'd have to fly out of the Philippines. Pero walang record dito na lumipad siya. Di ba? Yun ang, dun ang confusion.
Actually, the BI was already confronted with that. And there is no such Batik Air operations.
Oh.
It was an application, but it never got off the ground, the airline operations of Batik Air.
In the Philippines?
From the Philippines or anywhere else. The fact of the matter is that we believe that it was through some other means. Well, it's a question of trying to put up the pieces of evidence to support the belief or the suspicion. And that's the challenge on on us, on the law enforcement agencies, to really verify what really transpired here. Because this is a question that needs to be answered forthwith.
Oh, and frankly speaking, it could be a chartered flight.
We don't know. Chartered flight, special flight, whatever it is. Anything can happen when you have some mysterious activities that is always possible here.
Okay. All right. What will happen to Alice Go when she arrives? So you have Philippine authorities there. It's now Thursday. They're still processing. Most likely, is it fair to say that she might be coming into the country by Saturday already?
Hopefully. Hopefully.
Or, parang baka Friday is too soon. Diba?
I'm sorry, Karen. Hopefully, yes. Most likely soon. When we all are crossing our fingers that the presence of the Interior Secretary himself and the top police official in Indonesia would facilitate and fast track the process. But just in case the matter could become an immigration issue, we already sent, as I said earlier, our NBI and BI team. Let me backtrack a bit because the two other subjects, Sheila Go and Cassandra Ong, were brought back here simply because of an immigration to immigration arrangement. What do I mean by that? There were some arrangements that were made between the Philippine BI office and the Indonesian BI, who had custody of the two ladies in Batam at that point. And considering that they were denied entry, they were refused entry, we at the DOJ found a way by which this could be facilitated and avoid a protracted, expensive, and prolonged legal issue like what's happening in the Tevez case, the extradition. So we found a way, which is an administrative aspect, whereby the immigration people would simply return, exclude. It's a process of exclusion, similar to door-to-door in America. When you're refused entry by the immigration authorities, you're required to go back to where you came from, or your passport of nationality, of the country of passport, or where you choose. And, you know, it's a question of exclusion, removal, and extraction on the side of the requesting party. And that's very efficient, easy, quiet, and successful with respect to the two ladies. And if that comes to pass again, that this needs to be done, then it could be done also because it's similar to the two cases. Alice Goh is also there because of her having been the subject of a warrant of arrest from the Senate, and at the same time, because of her having been arrested. I don't know the details. We are not privy to the details of her arrest by the police, but we assume that it must be pursuant to the red notice. And if it were on the basis of that, then either a law enforcement solution or an immigration solution could come into play.
Anything else you would like to add, Undersecretary Vasquez, as we await the arrival of Alice Goh?
Abangan ang susunod na kabanata.
Yun na yun. Abangan. Pero pagdating niya, diretso. Pagdating niya, sir, diretso siya muna sa DOJ. Tama ba ito? Will you present her first?
Yes, supposed to be. Supposed to be. But it really all depends on what process that will be followed. If it were an immigration issue, then they would go through the same process as what happened to Sheila and Cassandra. They would be in the custody of a law enforcement, but the law enforcement would have to return them to BI because that is the arrangement, BI to BI, immigration issue. Uh-oh. And the matter could then be the subjected of some degree of debriefing. And in a matter of 1 or 2 days, just like what happened to the two, they were brought to the two houses of our Congress.
But this is the difference, because there are criminal charges filed against Alice Goh, right? You have money laundering. You also have falsifying public documents. I mean, she's not a Filipino. She ran for mayor. And among other things is, if nauna siya kasi sa DOJ and your prosecutors first get a hold of her, you may be able to get the information who helped her. Kasi ang mahirap, di ba? You know how it is that you can negotiate at some point, right? Reveal who helped you in government. How did you really escape, right? Ang mahirap pag nahawakan na yan ng iba and dumiretso sa Senate, and let's say it's a public hearing, if you are the witness, you'll no longer tell the truth. What's the point, right? Because in cases like this, they do want some negotiating leverage. So if the negotiating leverage is reveal who helped you, who assisted you.
Actually, that would be an investigation. Right? Technique. Yeah,
that's what the president wants.
You're such a grizzled investigator.
Am I right?
You should not be a newscaster. You should be with the NBI or the police. Anyway, just to follow your line of thought. It is necessary for a debriefing first to be conducted to somehow aid the law enforcement in their continuing and live investigation of this matter. Because remember, Alice Goh is just one piece of the puzzle. We need to piece up the entire picture for us to be able to really dig down deep and be able to bring into the light, so to speak, and resolve all the problems head on for the betterment of our country. I think that's the challenge. It's that Alice Goh is just one step. It's a big step, yes, but she's not the end all and be all. There's a bigger, much bigger problem, and she's just the tip of the iceberg, so to speak. We need to go deeper, and we need to it's a challenge to us all, and you in the news media would really be very important in this effort.
I want to thank you so much for joining me today. It's your first time on Head Start.
This is my second.
All right. Yeah, but I hope to see more of you. I do hope to see more of you, Undersecretary.
Thank you very much for the opportunity, Karen, and have a good morning. The skies are kind of dark still.
All right. Yes. Thank you so much. You take care, sir. Justice Undersecretary Raul Vasquez with us this morning. Thank you.